Tozer.
No.
And it's peaceful. It's cooling down finally. It's comfortable. I'm even finishing my coffee. There is a day coming when God will finish the work that He begun with us. I don't believe that we ever stop learning or that we ever stop growing, but I do believe that He accomplishes His purpose in us to present us without fault before the Father with exceeding joy, that when that day arrives, that we are prepared to recognize that the fire that God is love. It's just pure and simple. It's just a pure cleansing wholeness that love is. It is described in 1 Corinthians, but there's more to it. It's almost like it contains all the other emotions of self, but its reality is the content of all emotions, which boils down to the pure light or the pureness of what God is, which is love. Now, He's more, but He is love. And we aren't ready to deal with that, because the tenderness would, any one aspect of it would destroy us. It would just be too much for us to handle. But when we are perfected, then we'll be in God's presence. And that may be a fearful thing. At least God the Father will be. God never violates our freedom of choice. And whosoever will, let him take the water of life freely. Revelation 22:17. It is inherent in the nature of man that his will must be free. Man made in the image of God, who is completely free, man must enjoy a measure of freedom. This enables him to select his companions for this world and the next. It enables him to yield his soul to whom he will, to give allegiance to God or the devil, to remain a sinner or become a saint. After God, and God respects his freedom. God once saw everything that he had made, and behold, it was very good. To find fault with the smallest thing God has made is to find fault with its maker. It is a false humility that would lament that God wrought but imperfectly when he made man in his own image. Sin accepted, there is nothing in human nature to apologize for. This was confirmed forever when the eternal Son became permanently incarnated in human flesh. So highly does God regard his handiwork that he will not for any reason violate it. He will take 9 steps toward us, but he will not take the 10th. He will incline us to repent, but he cannot do our repenting for us. It is of the essence of repentance that it can only be done by the one who committed the act to be repented of. God can wait on the sinning man. He can withhold judgment. He can exercise long-suffering to the point where he appears lax in his judicial administration, but he cannot force a man to repent. To do this would be to violate the man's freedom and void the gift of God originally bestowed upon him. The believer knows he is free to choose, and with that knowledge he chooses forever the blessed will of God. In a nutshell, it's kind of like a theological term, and it's kind of like discussing things that are kind of crazy and diverse in ways to get down to a simple explanation, which is simply that God loves you. You know, I mean, bottom line, and because he loves you, he wants you to mature and to grow in that knowledge that he loves you. And the only way to do that is to let you make choices that are determinant upon your experience with him or without him. When you experience what it's like without him, then you choose to be with him. When you experience what it's like to be with him, then you don't want to be without him. It's that simple. That's all it boils down to. Because of what he's given, he won't do anything outside of letting you determine which way you will go. If you meet with God each day, God will meet you there. If you choose not to, and you go your own way, he will let you make that determination and allow you to step out from his protection and guidance. He will allow you to choose which way you should go, but he will arrange circumstances to bring you back. That is what love does. It's not easy to always understand God, because he's bigger than we are, he's greater than we are, he's more than we are, and he's so much beyond us, that the best we can ever hope to imagine is Jesus. And as we see Jesus, we get a pretty good picture of him, you know, because if we've seen Jesus, we've seen the Father. And in dealing with Jesus, there are times where he may mystify you also, because there's more to him than meets the eye. The reality of knowing God is just simply knowing him. It's not having him conformed into a complete understanding. It's just knowing him and that he loves you. If you know that, you know God.